policy.
Can we move the chair here because nobody is able to see me? Can we move the chair here? What would you like to stand and speak? Come.
Stand in and word.
No.
Please sit.
You should have a different.
Good morning to everybody. And I'm very much thankful for giving me this opportunity.
Straight away speak, no preamble.
Okay.
And what you are doing now? My
name is Sheshaya Chamurkunda. I'm doing social exclusion. I am doing my PhD in social exclusion inclusive policy in School of Social Sciences in University of Hyderabad. So I'll read out what I wanted to say because it would be very easy and also I can save some time. My name is Sheshaya Chamurkunda, native of Kagithalpur village, Nellore district of Andhra Pradesh, son of Chamurkunda Nagamanamma and Chanchuramayya. Currently working as research scholar in Center for the Study of Social Exclusion Inclusive Policy. Presently residing in University Hostel. I hereby state as follows. I am the eldest in the family. I have a younger sister. My parents are not literate. And also they are not alive today. My father worked as a bonded laborer till his death. I studied in my village school till 5th class and then got admission in the Andhra Pradesh Social Welfare Residential School where I studied until 10th class. I passed my 10th class with 68% marks. My mother died when I was in 9th standard. Recently, 1 year back, my father was also dead. I was an average student until 10th class. It therefore surprised me to find myself becoming a topper in both the years in intermediate level. After that, I joined a degree. Before I would like to mention about my degree joining, I would like to mention some difficulties which I faced after completion of my intermediate and degree. Because till intermediate I studied in Telugu medium background. Due to my poor parents and illiterate parents, I got 65% in my intermediate level in Telugu medium background, in Telugu medium. That too in economics, I got 89% of the marks in economics subject. So after completion of my intermediate in 2006, and I have seen one advertisement from the University of Hyderabad for the first time. I heard the name University of Hyderabad first time after completion of my intermediate level. In that newspaper, one advertisement has come up that this University of Hyderabad is going to offer 5 years integrated study in social science, both in social science and in sciences. From social sciences, in 2006 there was one subject that is economics. So I have decided to join in. I have decided to write their entrance examination in Central University for integrated MA in economics, because I got 89% 89 marks in economics, which is highly great in my background level. So that is in University of Hyderabad, economics will be in English medium. I have studied in my Telugu medium. So that anyhow, I have my interest is to get renowned universities like University of Hyderabad. Then I applied and I wrote the entrance exam. I qualified the entrance and I went for the I appeared for the interview. There I had to compete with the English medium background students who are from Hyderabad based, like Navodaya, Hyderabad Public School, and all. So that due to this lack of English medium, I could not be able to get through in 5 years integrated study in 2006. Then I had to come back to my village to join degree to continue my graduation. So I had to drop this golden opportunity to get into this University of Hyderabad in 2006. Then I was searching for the I was searching for the BA, because I have chosen my intermediate group as HEC, so that it is inevitable for HEC students to join to take BA in graduation level. So that I was searching for the college which has hostel accommodation, because after completion of during my intermediate, I struggled a lot to get food in my relatives, because after completion of my 10th class, my maternal uncle has taken care of me and my sister. He sent me and my sister to his brother's home. They are also very struggled to get food in their home also. So they could not able to sufficient adequate food for me and my sister in intermediate level. So that I have struggled a lot to get food in my intermediate. So that after completion of my intermediate, I have decided to join in college where hostel is being offered. So I could notice that there is a good college that in Kavali, which comes under the Nellore district, that is Jawahar Bharathi College, where so many social activists and so many IAS officers and so many academicians have completed their degree, their graduation. So that I have joined there. I have joined there for degree. I was an average student, 10th class 11. So I joined in my degree in Jawahar Bharathi Degree College. This college in a way saved me from hunger. As soon as I joined the hostel, I experienced a sense of freedom, thinking that I could at least eat 3 times a day. There I came across people who were in conditions worse than mine. During vacation, I worked in catering, painting, and construction work. And with that, I could earn some money by working in catering and construction work and painting. So with that money, I paid for fees and other expenses. It was these circumstances that increased my zeal and passion to study after degree. I got admission in Central University after completion of my degree because I had a desire to get into the higher education, Central University, like University of Hyderabad. After completion, I could not be able to get through in after completion my intermediate in Central University. But I had still desire to get into the that institution. So that, meanwhile, I wrote state level entrance examination for MA History in SV University, where I got 4th rank in state level. And then, I wrote Central University also for MA in History in English medium. For the first time I bought Shankar Narayana dictionary, English dictionary, to learn English. Because if at all want to join in English medium universities like University of Hyderabad and JNU, we should have at least to some spoken English. So that after completion of my final year only, I could buy this English Shankar Narayana dictionary, and then I have started to learn English words for the first time after the completion of my degree. So that and also I could know that there are books called NCERT, from where we can gain more knowledge than the state syllabus of books. Then I have bought these NCERT books for 6th class and 7th class, 7th standard NCERT books in English medium. Then I started to read for the first time in English. At any cost, I could by heart these English through English medium NCERT books nearly 15 to 20 essays in history for entrance of the MA in University of Hyderabad. So that I could by heart and I could I have written the entrance examination for which there is no interview at all for MA, so that I could enter into the, I could got through in main list for MA in history. Then I joined MA in English medium at University of Hyderabad in 2009. The difficulty of coping with English medium for someone who studied in Telugu medium is beyond words. I had to present seminars in English in front of a class of 55 people. Many of these students came from cities and well-off families. Imagine the atmosphere of a classroom that had these students and as first generation literates. On one hand, we were scared and shy, and on the other hand, we were sad and angry that we would get less marks if we didn't speak in class. But I also had a strong will to study. Till my third semester, I learned books by heart and wrote exams and got first class. Many of our teachers did not understand our problems. We were not paid enough attention. We were not given priority because in MA level I struggled a lot and I got humiliated by the students who were used to laugh at my when I was presenting my seminar paper and all. It was very bitter experience for the Dalits and as well as Girijans, the Adivasis who are come from remote areas and also who are come from Telugu medium background. In the fourth semester, I worked really hard to learn English because since I am working in a Ambedkar Students Association, this association seniors loan me to think rationally and loan me to study PhD, because there are many seniors in Ambedkar Students Association like me who are come from very privileged and unprivileged background, and also who are very poor and also very Telugu medium background. Now they have settled down in many central universities like JNU, University of Hyderabad, Gujarat Central University, Assam Central University as assistant professors. Their existence in Central University gave Philip to me to get MPhil, to do MPhil and PhD, because if you want to do MPhil PhD, you should have some English spoken English skills. At least we have to speak even little bit English by our own, so that through my seniors in association I have decided to learn by own, so to speak in English. Then after completion during my fourth semester only, I could know that there is a grammar for English which we should learn. Then I have started to learn grammar to speak in English through my senior. His name is Babu Shankar. So I started by fourth semester to learn grammar, and at least I spent 1 month to speak in English. I work hard, and I at least now I can able to speak in English in front of you. So that though I learn this little bit English, it is very difficult for me to get into MPhil education. MPhil, because there are many people here.
Sir, I would like to mention, I would like to emphasize on this issue very particularly, because here Dalits and minorities and Adivasis are very struggling a lot, and also this joining after completion of MA and after completion of MA before joining PhD, there is a so much struggle which Dalits and minorities and Adivasis are facing, because for general category students, after completion of their MA, they can easily get through MPhil and PhD, because they have good spoken English skills, and also when it comes to the Dalits and minorities and Adivasis, it is very difficult, and also by getting English MPhil and PhD, so their ages also will be increased. When our age is being increased, so many burdens will be coming from my families to take care of parents, to get married and all. There are many burdens between this academic space after completion of MA before joining the PhD. Because for general category, they can easily able to finish their MPhil in one year. When it comes to the Dalits, Adivasis and Muslims, it is very difficult for them to complete in 1 year. That's what they will have to take one more extension. So after completion of these 2 years of two years this MA, their years will be increasing, and also they will also have desire to get to PhD. And to get the PhD also, there will be lesser seats in PhD. In MPhil, more than 10 seats will be available. For PhD, there are 5 seats. For 5 seats also, many Delhi public school students will be coming. Coming usually, Hyderabad public schools coming. But village background people are not getting for PhD within the so. This after completion of this MA and all, so that these between these years they have they are struggling a lot, and these burdens led to the death of the Dalits and Adivasis and minorities in the universities, like, you know, in the renowned universities like University of Calcutta. That I would like to emphasize on this. Now, on the 3rd August 2015, this incident happened where we were accused of beating Sushil Kumar from ABVP. At that time, the Proctorial Board called us for depositions. We went and gave our depositions, and one week later, we got orders. These orders were sent to every department, including my HOD. The orders stated that this is last warning for you as well as for ABVP. I thought it was the end of the case. After that, I went home to help my sister on some work. While I was at home, I got a call from my department that I was suspended for one semester. I immediately returned to Hyderabad, and all of us asked the VC as to why a second set of orders were issued when the first order of warning was already given. The university then promised to set up a new committee, and the suspension was revoked. By the end of November, we came to know that the university was getting letters from Bandara Dattatreya and the HRD ministry. By 16th December, we got the third set of suspension orders. This was the third action on the same case. First, we got warning. Second was a full suspension for a semester. The third order said that we could complete our courses, but without hostel facilities and participation in social and political activities. All five of us came from agricultural labor families. If we rent rooms, it would cost us at least to 5,000 rupees, and we could not afford that. All of us needed to send half of our fellowship amounts to our home. How could we rent a place outside? We realized that this was injustice. There are very few central universities in our country. Students come from long distances and remote areas to study in central university. Even within the state, we travel almost 600 kilometers to reach here. Hence, the rule in a central university is to provide a hostel facility to every student who gets admission. It is our right. If hostel accommodation is not provided, it is as good as not getting an admission. Giving us admission and not hostel accommodation is one kind of boycott or discrimination. We felt humiliated. We didn't know where to go after the suspension. We decided that we will stay in the same university. So we stayed in the open for first 2-3 days in the cold. I got fever. So we put a tent. Rohit was very depressed, though he didn't show it to us. He used to keep asking why VC never came to meet us. Why is this happening to us? He was worried that our admission might get cancelled because political leaders were involved against us. He was worried that he might never be able to finish his PhD. Rohit and I used to share the same blanket which was offered by my senior. It was a big blanket. He used to share his thoughts with me. He told me that since he wasn't getting his fellowship money, he was forced to borrow money from others, from whom he used to get humiliation. In these conditions, he died. Thank you.
Suppose only one question, sir. University arbitrarily removes you from the hostel. Do you support government establishing welfare hostels outside the campus, welfare hostels for university students?
To operate to this university?
Apart from the university hostels.
Okay.
Suppose government establishes hostel outside, then the question of expulsion will not be there.
Because though. They have established these welfare hostels.
It is best
inside. I don't think so, sir.